but I saw your name in those files, bro.
I know, I'm a clone, nigga. I'm a third gen. You feel me?
Yeah. So you know already. Damn.
Everyone knows the name Geronimo, right? But no one knows really much more about him than that. Here's this amazing fighter who's fighting for his people. His people are being slaughtered. And at the time, he's really kind of one of America's great enemies. But then slowly, when people see he's fighting for his own people, he becomes a hero. What's crazy about the story is that when he dies, supposedly his skull is actually taken. In 2005, journalist Mark Wertman is researching a story about a group of Yale University World War I soldiers stationed at Fort Sill. And he stumbles across an incredible letter.
In it, it said, "We have Geronimo's skull, bones, and horse tack."
What I love about the story, the best part of it, is who takes it? It's supposedly Skull and Bones, one of the great secret societies. And for those who don't know Skull and Bones, it's Yale University, one of the great fraternities there.
Skull and Bones is the most elite and proportionally successful secret society in the world.
I mean, when you want to talk about the spooky secret societies, right, you got the Freemasons, you got the Illuminati, you got Skull and Bones, it's right there. And one of the primary suspects in the crime, let's just say last name is Bush. Recognize that last name? That's future Senator Prescott Bush, father of President George H.W. Bush and the grandfather of President George W. Bush. I think the reason why this story persists is it's not just a theft, and it's not just that you're robbing a grave, and it's not just that you have this really American hero in Geronimo, but that it might have been stolen by some of the future leaders of all of America.
What it's like to to be hated, to be faded, to telling only lies. But my dreams, they aren't as empty as my conscience seems to be. I have hours, only lonely. My love is vengeance that's never free. No one knows what it's like to feel these feelings.
Blood programmed heart bus, lung corrupted, blood, dripping blood from the lung, programmed chip, brain connected, brain programmed, no chip, no bug. Me and Mabel Keating, son.
Can I help you?
I need a program.
Can I help you?
I need a program. Yes, sir, you can help me. Please.
I'm gonna have to ask you to leave, please.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know what you've been told. I don't get out much these days. Waking young and feeling old, the days are no longer my own to piss away the waking.
Hopes that you know, right?
want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by robots. Need love too. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by robots. Need love too. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by robots. Need love too. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by you. They want to be loved by you.
Dr. James Hamlin is here. He's a staff writer for The Atlantic.
Deaths per day and deaths per day and
deaths per day and
that has become, it's such a large number that we have coping mechanisms to guard against having to deal with that. We become numb. Becomes meaningless because it's too tragic to deal with. And
because it's too tragic to deal with.
Today's video has some interesting aspects to it that I'm hoping I can help put this into more context because I can see how it can be very confusing. Now, let's look at the title, then we'll talk about it. Lady Gaga, Hunter Biden, threesome ritual. China drops hot new pics. Is that Lady Gaga with tattoos pixelated? Naked and smoking in Hunter Biden's hotel room with unidentified woman. And by the way, Joe Biden is a clone. As previously explained, the clones want the presidency. Okay, so this is the title, and let's look at what the article says. It says the general public is having a hard time with the cloning thing, but the clones do want to rule the world. Now, in this picture, everybody, I believe, is a clone except for Obama, who is a clone hybrid. So actually, they're all clones. But Obama being a hybrid. Why else would Lady Gaga be posing with these past presidents like she's the head boss? Like she's the queen bee? I'll scroll up in a moment, but let's look at this photo that was recently released by the Chinese government that shows someone who looks remarkably like Hunter Biden and Lady Gaga. Now, you might want to ask, why would Lady Gaga be in the bed, what looks like a bedroom, with Hunter Biden? And why is there somebody on the bed?
I'm your biggest fan, I'll follow you until you love me, Papa.
Papa runs.
I'm your biggest fan, I'll follow you until you love me,
Papa.
That their children will turn out fine if it's done properly with
he
proper
just said
screening.
70% failure.
You simply don't allow them. You simply.
What do you do with them?
Huh?
What?
Obviously,
do you do
they
with
miscarry.
Them?
They have to be terminated. I'm sorry. That is
that
a necessary price. No, you terminate. If you have a terribly deformed child, nature generally solves the problem by carrying a miscarriage.
How do you know they won't be born? Dolly's mutating. How do you know when the child?
She's a little fat because every journalist goes in there and gives her a piece of candy.
How do you know when that child is born?
And that's why she's overweight. You would be overweight too. Look at all of us. Most of us are overweight. We're not gene mutating. I know very much. You know what happened? Politics got involved.
It's not about politics.
No, they took the muscle of the state and put it behind who could breed and how they could breed, and that's just what you're trying to do.
Absolutely
telling people
not.
You have not
we
the right
saying
to reproduce.
That science should not create monsters.
And
that
you're
there
saying
are ethics
should, we
and
should
there
outlaw
are
science.
They discovered the key to creating what are known as organic robotoids. An organic robotoid is an artificial robot-like creature. It looks and acts exactly like a human being, and yet it is not human. A robotoid is alive in the biological sense, but it is an artificial life form. Robotoids respond to conventional routine medical tests in the same way as humans do. They eat, they drink, they breathe, they bleed if cut, and they can be killed. Robotoids can also think, but they think only in the sense that a computer thinks. Like any other computer, the brain of a robotoid has to be programmed for each assignment it is given.
Well, my understanding is that a lot of presidents have already been replaced.
That's right.